Hello 10th class, how are you? Hope all of you are happy as well as healthy. So today we are going to start chapter number 5 from chemistry, that is the periodic classification of element. Now classification means what? Classification, that means what? Categorization of certain things on the basis of particular property in the different groups is known as a classification. Classification, that means what? Sorting out the different type of element or compound basis or their similarity in their different property is called a classification. Now different way, different peoples, they are classifying the things. Suppose you are visiting to shopkeepers and if you want to purchase or if you want to collect detergent and powder, then immediately he will provide all the things. Why? Because he classifies all the things in different manner. That means what? If grocery shop is there, then he classifies all the things. That means what? Detergent one side, then cosmetic things another side, then grain and pulses in different compartment. So he kept all the things, soap, detergent, shampoo in one side, then another things. Suppose he has different type of food items, so he separated from in different way based on their property. So here different elements classify in different groups and different periods. So classification means what? Sorting out different type of element based on their different groups and periods. Now why it is necessary or necessity to this classify different element? इसकी need क्या है कि इतने सारे element हैं उसको classify करने की? So while classifying this element, it is easy to remember, is it? It is easy to use in different way, and these all the element means 100 elements, 118 elements are classified in different groups and period in periodic table. So in order to classify these elements, different scientists, they did work as well as they classify different element in different group and periods. So first of all, Dobernet scientist, he had given triad. Then second, Newland, law of octave, that means Newland scientist, he classify these elements. Then Mendeleev periodic table, Mendeleev scientist, he classify the element based on their property as well as atomic mass. Then we will learn here modern periodic law, modern periodic table, as well as trained in modern periodic table. That means what? We will learn that property of each and every element present in the modern periodic table. So let's start from Dobernet triads. Now triad means what? Group of three element is known as a triad. So Dobernet scientist, he classify different element. German scientist, he designed three triad as follow. He designed three triad. Triad means what? Group of three element. Now triad of alkali metals, triad of alkaline earth metals, as well as triad of halogen metals. So according to Dobernet, during 1820 he designed these triads. Now according to Dobernet, what he said, that he decided three element, and according to this theory, the middle element mass is average of first and third element mass. That means what? Dobernet ने तीन element को arrangement किया with increasing order of their atomic mass. He arranged three atoms विथ इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मास. लिथियम का मास कम है, सोडियम का मास उससे ज़्यादा है, पोटेशियम का मास उससे भी ज़्यादा है. सो ही अरेंज ग्रुप ऑफ एलिमेंट, बट इन दैट ग्रुप ही कंसिडर्ड ओनली 3 एलिमेंट्स विथ इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मास. एंड वॉट ही सेड दैट मिडल एलिमेंट इट्स एटॉमिक मास इज वॉट arithmetic mean of first and third element. So first he had shown that triad of alkali metals. Now lithium इसका atomic number है 3 और atomic mass क्या है 6.9 means what approximately 7. Sodium its atomic number is 11, atomic mass is 23. Potassium its atomic number is 19 and atomic mass is 39. Now according to Dobner, the mass of lithium and mass of potassium, if we take together and we take the mean of it, that gives you mass of sodium. So here if you take the mean of this 6.9 plus 39 divided by 2, you will get 22.95. That means approximately 23. That means what? Sodium its atomic mass is 23. So here this law is applicable. Whatever Dobner tried, so whatever he had given the information, here it is following. Now next he had given trade of alkaline earth metal. But whatever the triad he has given, according to that he had given some property based on these triad. Now first case he had given all these elements. What he said, all these elements are highly reactive. Ye sabhi elements kya hai? Reactive hai. Then all these elements when they react with water, they form base. That's why they and they form water soluble base, and that's why he had given the name as a alkali metals. And all these elements react with oxygen to form basic oxide, and they show the electropositivity. Valency is what? For all these elements, valency is what? +1. So some information also he had given with his tread. Now next tread he suggested, that is a tread of alkaline earth metal. In that case he took calcium, strontium and barium. As we know that calcium he took, its mass is 40, strontium its mass is 87.6 and barium its mass is 137.3. Now according to Dobner tread, he arranged all the elements with increasing order of their atomic mass, but the mass of average or mean of mass of first and last element, first and third element means 40.1 plus 137.3 upon 2 is equal to 88.65. That means what? It is near, approximately figure is almost, we are saying is almost similar. It is equal to 87.6. Actual mass of strontium is what? 87.6. That means yahan pe bhi Dobner tread ka approximately idea mass, middle element mass is what? Mean of first and last element mass. He got the same information over here for this second. And why he had given alkaline earth metal name, he had given as a alkaline earth metal? Because all these elements are metal. Then second thing, all metals form basic oxide. These metal, they form basic oxide, and these oxides are alkaline in nature and exist in earth crust layer. That's why he called alkaline earth metal. Alkaline oxides, they are basic in nature and they are present in nature, exist in earth. That's why he had given earth crust layer, we are getting in the form of oxide, and that's why he had given the name as a alkaline earth metal. Isiliye unhone naam kya diya, alkaline earth metal. Another property He said that these metals, alkaline earth metal, they are electropositive as well as their valency is what? 2. Plus 2, all these are the showing the valency. Next triad he had given. Triad means what? Group of 3 element. But he kept with increasing order of their atomic mass. So chlorine, bromine and iodine. Triad of halogen group. So triad of halogen group, halogen elements are there. Chlorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. These are the halogen group. So he took chlorine, bromine and iodine. Now according to the statement given by Dobbenheim, the mass of bromine is what mean of the mass of chlorine and iodine. So here atomic mass of chlorine is 35.5. Atomic mass of iodine is 126.9. And divided by 2, if we take the mean of this, it gives you value about 81.2. That means what? Near about exact mass of atomic mass given in periodic table is 79.9, near about 80. And he got 81.2. That means what? Approximately that value shows a similar value comes here. But whatever he explained is not totally true for all the element. According to that, he explained only few of that trend. And here also in halogen group, he said all these elements are non-metal and they combine with metal to form ionic compound. Suppose chlorine, they combine with metal and especially alkali metals, they form ionic compound. Suppose sodium is there, sodium plus chlorine, it gives you sodium chloride. Like that way, he had given the information. And all these elements are what? Electronegative in nature. These elements react with water and they form acid. Suppose water plus chlorine, it gives you hydrochloric acid. So with water, these type of element, they form acid. And all these elements have valency minus 1. So such a type of information given by this scientist. But this information is not sufficient, as we know that limitation we will learn here, because he had given only 3 trend. After that, scientist, they said that this classification was applicable only for few element. How it is applicable means just now we have seen about the halogen, alkali metal as well as alkaline earth metal. But what about the other element? All the elements could not arrange in triad. For example, nitrogen, phosphorus and arsenic. If we arrange these type of element with increasing order of their atomic mass, then have similar chemical property. But atomic masses of middle element, that means phosphorus comes in middle. So atomic mass of middle element, it should be sum of, or it should be mean of nitrogen and arsenic. But he got the different value other than this one. Atomic mass of middle element, actual atomic mass of phosphorus is 31, which is much lower than the average or mean of the atomic mass of nitrogen and arsenic, which is equal to 44.45. So here he could not explain why such wide difference comes in between the middle atomic mass as well as actual atomic mass of phosphorus. So this triad, that means Dobbenheim triad, is only important for the historically way. So this system of classification has only the historical importance, because he could not explain about the different other elements and he could not say about this type of element how this can be possible. Now let us start next Newland's law. Another scientist, Newland, he had given the Newland's law of octave. Octave means what? group of three element based on musical notes. Now how he had given these type of element, उन्होंने क्या दिया, Newland's law जो octave है, उन्होंने Indian as well as English musical notes के according उन्होंने क्या arrange किया, different type के elements को. When elements are arranged in order of increasing atomic masses in rows, the property of eighth element are repetition of the property of first element, just like in the musical notes. So this is called the law of octave. उनको law of octave क्यों बोला गया, क्योंकि octave means what, according to Indian musical notes, Indian के सुर के हिसाब से जब हम लोग भी use करते हैं, सारे गामा पादा नी सा, सा means once again, जो एट्थ एलिमेंट आता है उसकी प्रॉपर्टी सेम होती है फर्स्ट एलिमेंट के हिसाब से. तो ही अरेंज ऑल द एलिमेंट बेस्ड ऑन सारे गा मा प द नी. नी के बाद में इंडियन म्यूजिकल नोट्स में वंस अगेन हम लोग जब सुर बोलते हैं तो क्या आता है, सा. तो यहाँ पे फर्स्ट एलिमेंट की प्रॉपर्टी और एट्थ एलिमेंट की प्रॉपर्टी क्या होनी चाहिए, सेम होनी चाहिए. अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ही अरेंज्ड ऑल द एलिमेंट इन डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स. सेम वे हियर दैट दीज म्यूजिकल नोट्स, वी कैन से दैट इंग्लैंड म्यूजिकल नोट्स आर डो रे मी फा सो ला ती. डो रे मी फा सो ला ती, ऐसे करके उन्होंने म्यूजिकल नोट के हिसाब से, फॉरेन म्यूजिकल नोट्स एज वेल एज इंडियन म्यूजिकल नोट्स के हिसाब से वेस्टर्न में क्या यूज़ किया जाता है, डो रे मी फा सो ला ती डो, ऐसे म्यूजिकल नोट्स यूज़ किए जाते हैं वेस्टर्न में. और इंडिया में सारे गामा पादा नी सा, सा मीन्स वॉट, एट्थ, वंस अगेन शोइंग द रिपीटेड प्रॉपर्टी एज अ फर्स्ट एलिमेंट. So he arranged all the element with increasing order of their atomic mass. So hydrogen, first he kept hydrogen, then lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. Once again, he kept below that hydrogen, fluorine, lithium ke niche, sodium, magnesium, helium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur. Chlorine, potassium, calcium, chromium, titanium, manganese, iron. Like this way, he arranged all the element in different groups and different periods. But he could not explain about the group as well as period, but he arranged all the element with increasing order of their atomic mass. And he said, like Indian musical notes, each and every eighth element shows the similar property as a first element. So according to this law, Newland की law के हिसाब से chlorine की property same होनी चाहिए hydrogen की property जैसे, chlorine की property fluorine जैसी होनी चाहिए. The same way यहाँ पे sodium की property lithium, suppose if we are considering lithium is a first element, तो lithium के बाद में यहाँ पे एट्थ एलिमेंट क्या आएगा, सोडियम आएगा. तो सोडियम की प्रॉपर्टी कैसे होनी चाहिए, लिथियम जैसी होनी चाहिए. सेम वे पोटेशियम की प्रॉपर्टी सोडियम जैसी, मीन्स दिस ग्रुप हैव सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टी. द सेम वे इफ वी आर कंसीडरिंग मैग्नीशियम, तो मैग्नीशियम की प्रॉपर्टी इट शुड बी सिमिलर लाइक अ बेरिलियम. सो लाइक वाइज ही अरेंज ऑल द एलिमेंट्स विथ इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मास as well as based on their musical notes. And he said there will be the repetition of the property. Each element shows the repeated property as a first element. But here he could not classify the element up to, he could explain up to calcium. After calcium, his property cannot be properly, he arranged his element and he could not explain why these property are quite different from these elements. So after the discovery more number of elements, this law was not applicable properly for different type of element after calcium.
But the merits of this classification was Newland gave the very important conclusion. उन्होंने एक important conclusion दिया. There is some relation between order of atomic mass and repetition of the property of the element.
डोबरनर ने ओनली एटॉमिक मास के बारे में बताया बट रिपीटेशन ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी के बारे में लिटिल बिट इंफॉर्मेशन न्यूलैंड ने दिया बेस्ड ऑन देयर म्यूजिकल नोट्स. जैसे यहाँ पे बताया एट्थ एलिमेंट की प्रॉपर्टी सिमिलर एज ए फर्स्ट एलिमेंट की होगी लाइक दैट ही अरेंज द एलिमेंट बट अप टू कैल्शियम
ही क्लासीफाई प्रॉपरली द एलिमेंट बट आफ्टर दैट दिस थियरी इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल.
So let us learn more about the its a limitation. So here if we say that new limitation to this theory is applicable only up to calcium, that means up to lighter element. 1 to 20 element aap logo ne kiye hain 9th class mein, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium up to calcium. 20 atomic mass hai, 20 एटॉमिक नंबर है कैल्शियम का, 40 मास एटॉमिक मास. तो वहाँ तक ही ये थियोरी एप्लीकेबल थी बट लाइटर एलिमेंट तक. बट उसके बाद में जो एलिमेंट एट्थ एलिमेंट आए तो क्रोमियम की प्रॉपर्टी बोरान से सिमिलर नहीं थी. लाइक दैट वे दिस टाइप ऑफ एलिमेंट्स मैंगनीज कुड नॉट शो द सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टी एज अ नाइट्रोजन. लाइक दैट प्रॉब्लम वर क्रिएटेड. न्यूलैंड एज्यूम देर आर ओनली 56 एलिमेंट. यहाँ पे उन्होंने क्या एज्यूम किया, ओनली 56 एलिमेंट एग्जिस्ट इन नेचर, नो न्यू एलिमेंट वुड बी डिस्कवर्ड इन फ्यूचर. उन्होंने क्या बोला, फ्यूचर में नो न्यू एलिमेंट कैन बी डिस्कवर्ड. ही कुड नॉट थिंक अबाउट द हैवियर एलिमेंट इफ फाउंड फर्दर. उन्होंने कुछ ऐसा भी न्यू एलिमेंट हैवियर एलिमेंट के बारे में भी नहीं सोचा. ओनली He discovered 56 एलिमेंट हैं तो 56 ही एलिमेंट रहेंगे और फ्यूचर एलिमेंट में कुछ पॉसिबिलिटी नहीं है. Then he placed even two element together with similar property in the same block. Different property. He kept two different element with different property in same slot. Now
तो एक ही स्लॉट में उन्होंने क्या रखा, दो अलग अलग एलिमेंट रखे.
नाउ कोबाल्ट एंड निकल ही केप्ट टुगेदर इन वन स्लॉट. सेम वे सीरियम एंड लेंथेनाइड ही केप्ट इन वन स्लॉट. ही कुड नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाई ही केप्ट दीज टू एलिमेंट टुगेदर इन वन स्लॉट. इवन दो ये इनकी क्या था, ड्रॉबैक था. कोबाल्ट निकल क्या है, मेटल है. फ्लोरीन क्लोरीन क्या है, नॉन मेटल है. तो ये जो है उनके साथ में मेटल और नॉन मेटल को क्या किया, एक ही ग्रुप में रखा. देन एक ही कॉलम में उन्होंने फिक्स किया. ही कुड नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाई ही केप्ट लाइक दिस वे. इवन दो आयरन रिजेंबल विथ कोबाल्ट एंड निकल बट ही प्लेस्ड फार अवे फ्रॉम इट. नाउ आयरन की प्रॉपर्टी, आयरन कोबाल्ट निकल ये क्या है, सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टी वाले हैं. तो आयरन को लास्ट कॉलम में रखा और कोबाल्ट एंड निकल को कहाँ, फर्स्ट कॉलम में रखा. ही कुड नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाई ही केप्ट लाइक दिस वे. नोबल गैसेस वर डिस्कवर्ड एट लेटर स्टेज सो होल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ टेबल वॉज डिस्टर्ब बाय देयर इंक्लूजन इन दिस टेबल. नोबल गैसेस का डिस्कवरी तो बाद में हुआ, उनके लिए भी उन्होंने कुछ आइडिया नहीं दिया, नहीं तो कोई वैकेंट प्लेस रखा नोबल गैसेस के लिए. तो दिस वे हिज थियरी वॉज फेल. सो दीज आर द न्यूलैंड्स लिमिटेशन एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. इट इज़ एप्लीकेबल अप टू लाइटर एलिमेंट, कैल्शियम तक वो एप्लीकेबल था. डोबरनर ने क्या बताया कि सॉरी दिस न्यूलैंड ने व्हाट ही सजेस्टेड, ओनली 56 एलिमेंट एग्जिस्ट इन नेचर. और ऐसा भी बताया गया कि नो न्यू एलिमेंट वुड बी डिस्कवर्ड इन फ्यूचर. उन्होंने तो पहले से ही बता दिया कि न्यू एलिमेंट फ्यूचर में पॉसिबिलिटी नहीं है. इंश्योरेंस दे दिया कि देयर आर ओनली 56 एलिमेंट. ही प्लेस्ड इवन टू एलिमेंट हैविंग डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टी टुगेदर इन द सेम स्लॉट. कोबाल्ट और निकल दोनों की प्रॉपर्टी क्या है, अलग अलग है. तो भी उन्होंने क्या फर्स्ट कॉलम में और सेम स्लॉट में रखा, और किसके साथ रखा, नॉन मेटल के साथ में रखा, सेम कॉलम में जहाँ पे नॉन मेटल थे वहाँ पे कोबाल्ट और निकल को साथ में एक ही स्लॉट में रखा। आयरन की प्रॉपर्टी किसके, कोबाल्ट और निकल के जैसी है, बट ही प्लेस्ड फार अवे फ्रॉम कोबाल्ट और निकल को फर्स्ट कॉलम में रखा और आयरन लास्ट कॉलम में। एंड इन नोबल गैसेस के लिए भी उन्होंने कुछ प्लेस, एम्प्टी प्लेस ही कुड नॉट शोन इन हिज टेबल। सो वट एवर, न्यूलैंड फर्स्ट डोबर ने ट्रेड दिया गया एंड सेकंड न्यूलैंड्स ट्रेड, न्यूलैंड्स लाफ ऑक्टिव दिया गया। लाफ ऑक्टिव क्यों रखा गया, बिकॉज इट इज़ गिवन बेस्ड ऑन म्यूजिकल नोट्स, इंडियन एज वेल एज वेस्टर्न म्यूजिकल नोट्स। अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ही एक्सप्लेन हिज दिस टेबुलर फॉर्म एंड ही कुड नॉट एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द पीरियड एज वेल एज दिस ग्रुप, बट group of 8 element and group of 7 element and repeated 8 element shows the repeated property as the first element he arranged with increasing order of their atomic mass. Now after this, Mendeley came and he discovered a systematic periodic table. Now let us see about the Mendeley's periodic law. Now according to Mendeley periodic table, now he had during his time period he discovered 63 element. He arranged all the 63 element in order with increasing mass in horizontal rows and different periods. During this arrangement he found the elements were similar property came in the same column, which is he called group. He used chemical property like hydride formation and oxide formation and classification he done in the same group. Repetition of the property of the element after certain interval of time period he called as a periodicity. Periodicity means what, after certain time period the properties showing the repetition, and that word he has given as a periodicity. Now periodic table, he has given, periodic table is what, systematic arrangement, a tabular form or the chart way of these elements he arranged, and that periodic table is a chart of element arrangement of all the element, known element in such a way that element having similar property occur in the same group as well as a column. Now the properties of the elements in the periodic function of their atomic masses. What he said, property of element are the periodic function of their atomic mass. So he arranged all the elements based on their atomic mass with increasing order of their atomic mass as well as property. Now periodic table, as we have discussed, it is what, chart of element in such a way that element having similar property occur in the same column and group. Now Mendeley ne kya bataya, 63 element in 6 period, that means rows, and 8 groups, that means what, vertical columns are known as groups and horizontal rows are known as period. So 63 element unhone arrange kiye, kaise arrange kiye, 6 period mein and 8 group mein. He indicated the groups by Roman number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that way up to 8 Roman number he indicate different groups. Unko identify kiya group 1, group 2, aise karke. Element of 1 to 7th group are divided in subgroup. Unhone kya kiya? First se leke 7th group ko subdivide kiya A and B part mein. In group 8th, only 9 elements were discovered in the form of red. जो लास्ट ग्रुप था उनकी पीरियोडिक टेबल में, तो वो क्या था, उसमें 9 ओनली एलिमेंट थे, बट वो जो 9 एलिमेंट थे, 3-3 एलिमेंट मीन्स ग्रुप ऑफ 3 एलिमेंट ही केप्ट टुगेदर इन अ वन स्लॉट.